Chess queens are trained to attack on sight. They see a piece of the other color, they capture it. That's their job. Those are normal queens. I want to tell you about peaceable queens. The question is, you have a chessboard of a certain size. It could be 8x8 or it could be 4x4. You would like to put down as many queens as you can, some black queens and some white queens, but they must not attack each other. Two constraints in this problem. Equal numbers, as many as possible, and they do not attack queens of the opposite color. So this is a problem that Don Knuth told me about in 2014. And I like the problem a lot because it has some lovely pictures. It's an easily stated problem and we don't know much about it. And there's a really incredible conjecture. Suppose we have a 4x4 chessboard and we want to put down black queens and white queens so they don't attack each other. So if you put two black queens in the two corners and two white queens in the two middle squares, the black queens do not attack the white queens, and the white queens don't attack the black queens. The most you can put down is two. There's no conflict when two white queens can see each other. Here, the white queens want to avoid being seen by the black queens and vice versa. This is a lovely problem because it's really, really hard. We know very few terms. So let me show you what we actually know about this. So for a 2x2, if you put a black queen here, it attacks the other squares. For a 1x1, you can't do anything. So what we know is that for a 1x1, the answer is 0. For a 2x2, the answer is 0. What about a 3x3? If we put a black queen here, it attacks all the squares except these two. So we could put a white queen here. We could put a white queen here too, but we'd have two white queens and we cannot put two black queens. So the numbers have to be equal. Okay, all you can do is one. One of each color is the max. Four, it's two. Two is the most we can do. So what about five? There are actually a lot of solutions to the 5x5, but there's one which is overwhelmingly nice. And you put four at the corners and you put four in the other obvious places. There, 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 and there. And you see they cleverly avoid each other and you can't do more. So for five, the answer is four. For six, you can do five. And for seven, I think you can do seven. On a regular chessboard, you can do nine. Nine black, nine white, and they don't attack each other. And you notice they come in clumps. And that seems to be a very good way to do it. If you go to a bigger board, then for nine, we can do 12, 10, 14. For an 11 by 11 board, you can put 17 black queens and 17 white queens. 12, 21, and 13, 24. And very recently, just a couple of weeks ago, someone found the next term, which is 28. Beyond this, we don't know. You can use things like simulated annealing to run to get lower bounds, to get things that look pretty good and maybe optimal. And you can use integer programming to get upper bounds, to show that you can't get more than such and such. But the exact value is not known beyond that point, although we have some conjectures. So here is a very plausible looking solution, which has 58 black queens and 58 white queens on a 20 by 20 board. And this is a construction which says if you generalize this and put the queens into four five-sided clumps, a clump here, a clump here, a clump here, and a clump here, then you can do very well as we know, in every case we've looked at, except one small case, the answer is at least 7n squared over 48 for an n by n board. So four clumps, which are five-sided, this picture here shows the general situation. Now, could this really be optimal? We don't know. I think it's a beautiful question. So I run this collection, this database, called the Online Encyclopedia of Integer Sequences. And when we got to 250,000 sequences, it's not that much, but to us it seems like a lot. All different, all interesting, hopefully. They're all numbered. So the first one is A1, then A2. Normally they come in every time a new sequence comes in, it gets the next free A number. And we were around 250,000. So we had a competition to see which would get the sequence number A, 250,000, A250000. I collected the votes. I did what is traditional. I made my candidate win. And here it is. Lovely problem. An amazing conjecture. Could this really be the right answer? Is this when God is playing chess with the universe? Is this where he puts his peaceable queens? It could be, or it could not be. It's a toss-up right now. Hopefully we'll get more data. You know, what I would do if I added a team of assistants, I'd pick, say, a 30 by 30 board and use some hill climbing method or Hook Jeeves pattern matching optimizer to find. You set it up as an optimization problem. It's an integer programming problem. Maximize the total number subject to the constraints. And the constraints are, for each row and column and diagonal, you don't have black and white on the same row.
So I've been looking at Brilliant, today's episode sponsor, for some chess-related puzzles, particularly ones about the queen. And there were plenty, actually, but here's one I liked. What's the biggest number of white queens that can be placed on a chessboard in such a way that a black king, also placed on the board, is not under attack, and you can place the king wherever you think is most profitable? You got any idea? You're also asked to ponder this for a chessboard of any size. Now, if you like puzzles, quizzes, courses, things like this, Brilliant is the place to be. Their daily challenges are especially popular and always worth a look. Have a look at some of these. So whether it's just for fun, or to get serious about upping your problem-solving skills, giving yourself a bit of a brain upgrade, check out brilliant.org/numberphile. The address there's on the screen. Using the numberphile suffix, that's going to get you 10% off one of Brilliant's premium subscriptions. That unlocks everything on the site. That's brilliant.org/numberphile.
28. Another way of saying 28 is 28. But I'm not sure that that's the right 28. Maybe you want a different 28. 28?